So, here we are again, and it's all about performance, and we will have a performance showdown between our CSDR as the one contestant, and on the other hand, we will have the plug flow reactor as the second contestant. So, what do we have? Plug flow reactor, continuous the tank reactor. Yeah. Even though it is in the name, be reminded, of course, power input does not necessarily need to be steering. We would have an inlet here, an overflow, and here, inlet, overflow. We will have a volume flow, in and out. We were looking at the ideal reactors at constant volume. So, what do we need? Let's look again at our lecture action. Yeah, turning students from unhappy state to happy state. With some rate equation here, first order, non-reversible, and that's about it. So, and we've seen, and you may refer to the other short inputs on that topic, that there are performance equations, yeah, and we can look at conversion as one measure for that. So conversion of unhappy students, and as we assume here only this reaction takes place, and I was with you on that, this is a very coarse model for a lecture. There can be other states, of course, yeah, so there's a multiple tune of reactions going on there, but if selectivity is one, then this is the same as the yield, and this would then be the concentration of happy students compared to the initial concentration of unhappy ones entering the reactor. And the performance equations for that were rather interestingly that we saw that actually, if you look at yield and conversion being the same here, now we could see that actually in this blue one, this was dominated by our dimensionless double Köhler model.
Yes!
Yield in this reactor. Conversion would be 1 minus 1, 1 plus the Dampfkühler number as given there. So this is the performance equation for the continuous state tank reactor. And performance for the plug flow reactor, yield, looking at happy students here, is given by 1 minus e to the power of minus the Dampfkühler number. So what can we do to look at the comparison? We can now make a plot, as I may have done, for this kind of equation, saying, okay, let's look at the performance. Here, for the same Dampfkühler numbers, so it's either this one or this one. So the neutral one, let's look at the comparison. Dampfkühler 1 as the x-axis, or the, and here we have conversion or yield, which is the same here for both reactors. And what you can see that direction here, and this is either getting larger because reaction is getting faster, or you give it more time, or both. So if no reaction, of course, there is nothing happening at all. And then they rise rather quickly here. And you see also that in view of conversion, so in view of your happiness, this the PFR actually outperforms the CSDR. That may not look that dramatic, But if you look here at it approximately a Damkreuter number of 2, you get about 65% conversion, but for the PFAR you already get more than 80% conversion. This may make a huge difference, even more so if you consider the same conversion level. So let's look here at, for example, 80% about here, and you hit that already at a Damkreuter number of about 2, yeah, and you hit the same conversion at a Damkreuter number of about 3 here, and that, if you keep everything the same, means that you would need a much longer residence time for the same reaction to perform equally in the same, in otherwise the same conditions. So in this first order reaction, it is absolutely clear that the plug flow reactor outperforms the continuous stirred tank reactor. Let's look at rate for this first order reaction. Yeah, so we have the rate for this first order reaction as a function of unhappy students. And that is, for first order reaction, rather simple, because we have no unhappiness, there will be no conversion, no rate, and we have a first order one where we actually find our k here. If this is 1, this will be k, so this will be the slope of this line. What happens in the plug flow reactor is that you actually will be able to use the full extent. So you start here, if this is your initial rate, so you actually will start here, yeah? And you will use a large proportion here of the same higher rates here. Yeah? So this will then be your actual rate at the end of the reactor. So you will use this. Yeah. Whereas in the continuous stirred tank reactor, you're stuck with one steady state concentration in the reactor, and therefore you will lose a lot of this kind of rate here, yeah, in terms of conversion to happiness. And that is the reason why you have that. So for first order reaction, you can also show that this is true for second order reactions as well, that you will benefit much from doing the plug flow reactor. And this, of course, leads me to the conclusion that for lecture, yeah, continuously a lecture, hard to envision, yeah, but we also saw that this actually is the same as a batch, but not in, space, but in time. And therefore, it concludes that also a batch will outperform such a reaction here. Yeah? And this means, of course, that you will get the most out of any lecture attending it from the start to the end, and using much more of the rate than arbitrarily hopping on and off. And that is, of course, something which is a good argument against punctuality as well. Thank you for your attention at this point.